Hey everybody, Chris here, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create an animated map like this one in After Effects completely from scratch. You're just going to need two things to get started: the map you want to use, and the icon you want to use if you want to have a car, train, plane, whatever, follow your path. If you don't know where to find any of these elements, I'll put a couple links to my favorite resources in the description of this video. Alright, let's get started. We'll start by clicking on New Composition. I'm going to title this Map Animation. My project settings are 1080p at 25 frames a second, and my duration is set to 10 seconds. Click OK. Now let's add our assets to the project. We have our US map and our car emoji. I'm going to drag those here to the project panel. Next, drag the US map into your composition. Hit S to bring up the scale property. I'm going to scale it up a little bit already and reposition it as I want. Now we need to draw our path. To do that, make sure you deselect the map layer, and then go up and select the pen tool. Make sure your fill is set to none and that your stroke is set to solid color, the color of your choice, and I have my width set to 12 pixels. Now we're going to click to add points and draw our path, and as we do it, I'm going to click, hold, and drag, and you'll see that it adds these handles. This adds a smoothness to the path that you'll see. It rounds out all these points. And that really makes this animation look smooth in the end. And you can adjust them as you want after the fact. Now that we have our path, let's make it look a little bit better and let's add some animation to it. To do that, let's dive into our attributes for our shape layer. I'm going to expand a few sections here until I see stroke. And then down here, we have a section called dashes. If you hit the plus sign here, now it turns our solid line into a dotted line, and we can increase this value until we have a dotted line that looks good to us for our path. I think that looks pretty good. Now we need to add some animation to it. To do that, go to this Add section and choose Trim Paths. Expand this section, and you'll see we have some options here to customize. I'm going to go forward in the timeline to about 4.5 seconds. Then I'm going to click the stopwatch here to add a keyframe. Then I'm going to go back to the beginning of our timeline here, and I'm going to take this 100 all the way down to 0. So now if we play it, you'll see that our dotted line animates on. This is looking pretty good, so let's add our car to the mix now. Click your car and drag it into the composition as well. Then hit S to adjust the scale, and scale it down to what feels right for your animation. I think that looks pretty good. Now we want to add the motion data so that this car follows the path as it gets revealed. To do that, go to the path section under your shape and expand it and select the path that has the stopwatch next to it. Just click on it so it's selected, then hit Command C or Control C on a PC to copy this information. Then click on your car layer and hit the P key to reveal the position information. Select that and then hit Command V or Control V to paste the position data. Now you'll see that we've added some keyframes here in our timeline, but the issue is that these keyframes don't line up with the keyframes from our path. So we just need to make sure to drag this first keyframe to the same location as our path's first keyframe, and same thing with the last one. Make sure that it lines up with the last one from the path. And now you'll see we have our car following the path and revealing the dots along the way. That's already looking pretty good, but we can make it look even better. When you have your trim paths section expanded, you'll be able to see the keyframes. Highlight both of the first two keyframes from both layers, right click and choose keyframe assistant, easy ease out. Then on the last two keyframes, do the same thing and select easy ease in. This gives a nice smooth start and end to our animation. Okay, I know some of you might be tempted to click away at this point. You might think you got everything you came here to get, but in the last 2 minutes of this video, I share two more tips that really add a professional touch to your animations. And the last one is something that I use in all kinds of After Effects projects, not just this specific map animation concept. So stick around, it's worth it. Okay, we're looking pretty good, but there are still two things that I like to do to give this animation a little bit more life. As you can see, the car is going up and down, and it would be nice to have the car rotate a little bit as it does this to really follow that path. In order to do this, select your car layer, right-click, and go to Transform, and down to Auto Orient. Then you can select Orient Along Path and click OK. Now you can see the car rotated. So as it follows the path, it now turns along with any turn that the path makes. Okay, the final piece that I like to do is to give this entire window a little bit of animation. To do that, I'm going to make all of our current layers a bit small, and I'm going to go up to Layer, New, Null Object. Then I'm going to select our first three layers, and I'm going to grab this squiggly line. I'm going to click and drag it over to the null object. This is known as the pick whip, and it basically links these three layers to this new null object that we created. Now I'm going to hit the S key and then hold Shift and hit P to reveal scale and position information for this layer. Now we can add keyframes to this one layer and it'll control all three layers at the same time. I'm going to go to the beginning of our timeline and add keyframes to the position and scale here because I think this is a good starting point for this animation. Then I'm going to scroll to the end of our animation and I'm going to increase the scale quite a bit, another 140% here. And then I'm going to reposition the shot as well. I think that looks pretty good. I'm going to do the same easing on these keyframes as I did before. So on the first ones, I'm going to say easy ease out. And on the last ones, I'm going to say easy ease in. And now we have our final result. Okay, a final request on the way out. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Those things keep me really motivated to create future videos. And if you have any special requests or questions, please feel free to leave a comment and I will do my best to answer them. Cheers.